Today we will discuss about length of path of contact in gears. Okay, so this is a derivation. Here we have the gears and the pinions. So the gears and pinions will be there. Pinion will be there. Let us consider this. So let this represent circle represent the pitch circle diameter of the so let this be O1 and let this one be O2. This is for pinion and this is for gear. Okay, so O1 is the center for pinion and O2 is the center for gear. And this circle is the pitch circle diameter for the pinion. And we have the above this one, we have the addendum circle. Okay, let this be the addendum circle. And let this be addendum circle. And we have dedendum circle below this. Okay. So this is the dedendum circle. And all these three circle belongs to pinion. Now we'll write the same thing for the gears also. So for gears, now for the gear, this is the pitch circle diameter, and this is the addendum circle, and this will be the dedendum circle. Okay, so now for further details you can go through this, the law of gearing, how these gears will be meshed. Okay, that is come across under law of gearing. According to law of gearing we are getting this, that is see, this is the point where the dedendum circle meets and this is the point where the pitch circle diameter meets and this is the point where the addendum circle meets. Okay, so let this, we'll name these points, let this be P and let this point be K and this one be L. Okay, now let's join this and extend this. Here also you join and extend. Okay, so now this is the schematic that we require to derive the equation for the length of path of contact. Okay, so now we will join. Okay, O1P. O1P. What is the O1P represents? O1P represents, what does O1P? O1P is equal to the small r, that is the radius of the pinion. Okay, now O2P. O2P will be the capital R and it is for the gear. Okay. Now let's join O1L. If you join O1L, we'll consider the pinion and we'll join O1L. O1L is the addendum circle radius point. So pinion, so L is what? It is addendum circle radius point. O1 corresponds to the pinion, so we have to take it as a small r, RA. Okay, O1 is addendum circle radius. Circle radius. Okay, similarly, we can also join O2K. So O2K is also joined. So O2K is the addendum circle, addendum circle radius, but it is for the gear. Okay, so we'll take it as addendum circle radius for gear. Okay, now if you can, we need to draw the normals to this. From O1 we have to draw the normal to the line joining this KL. Okay, if you draw the normal, this is a perpendicular line, so this will come to be O1M. And similarly, if you join the normal, if you draw the normal, so this is 90 degree, so this will become N. Okay, this is our point N. So O1M and O2N are the normals. O1M and O2N are the normals that is drawn from the center of the pinion and gear. Okay. Now if you can see that, see this KL is nothing but the path of arc, length of path of contact. Okay. That is what we are supposed to find out. We'll come to that point later. So now if you can consider the triangle O1MP. O1MP is a triangle. Now O1MP is one triangle, O2PN is another triangle. Okay, so now we will consider the triangle O1ML. Okay, that is with respect to the addendum point O1ML. So now in a triangle O1ML, okay, in triangle O1ML, what is ML square? ML square is equal to O1L square minus O1M square. So in triangle O1ML, what is ML square? ML square, ML square comes to be O1L square minus O1M square. Okay, so we can write this again. ML square, O1L is nothing but small RA square minus what is O1M square? O1M square. So what is the O1M square? See, this is angle, the pressure angle phi. So again, this is a vertical opposite phi angle. Now here we, if you consider the right angle triangle O2N and the right angle triangle, if you consider this, okay, 90 degree together, phi plus whatever the angle is 90 degree, so this side will comes to be RA cos phi. Okay, so this side will be RA sin phi and this O2N will be RA cos phi. So the same thing happens here also. O1M. Let me complete this right angle triangle. So this guy will be R sine phi. This is small r. And this will be R cos phi. Okay. So this is RA and this is RA. Small RA cos phi, small RA sin phi. Okay. So now what is O1M square? We'll get RA. Square cos square phi. Okay. So you remove this subscript is not, don't want. So it is not with respect to addendum or dedendum. It is a right angle triangle at this point. Okay. So let this will be, that is ML square is equal to RA square minus R square cos square phi. Okay. R square cos square phi. Now what is ML? ML will be the square root of this, that is RA square minus R square cos square phi. Okay. So call this as equation 1. Call this as equation 1. Now we want the length PL. Okay. We want the length PL. This is ML. What is PL? We have ML. What is PL? Okay. PL is equal to ML minus MP. Okay. PL is equal to ML minus MP. Okay. So now you can write this equation. ML square is known. That is ML is known. RA square minus R square cos square phi. What is MP? MP. Okay. So MP comes to be, it is whatever the MP is there, this component is nothing but is a parallel. Okay. This R sine phi. Okay. So this guy will be exactly the same thing what is here. Okay, that is R sin phi. Okay, so here R sin phi is nothing but is your MP. Okay, now let us call this as equation 2. Okay, so similarly now we got what is ML. Similarly, if we consider triangle O2NK, so this is for with respect to gear. So far what we have done this for with respect to pinion, that is ML, what we found out is for with respect to pinion by considering the triangle O1ML. O1ML. Now if you are going to consider O2NK, that is O2NK, O2NK, okay. So if you are considering this triangle, so now similarly what we have calculated here, the same thing if you go through the derivation means, that is you will get KN square is equal to O2K square minus O2N square. So this comes to be RA square minus R square cos square phi. So KP will be equal to KN minus NP. KN minus NP. So KP, this amount KP is equal to NK, that is KNK minus NP. Okay. So this will give RA square minus r square cos square phi minus r sine phi. Okay, so we can call this as equation 3. Now what is required is the length of path of contact. Length of path of contact is nothing but this KL. Whatever this KL is there, this is the length of path of contact. So KL is equal to KP plus PL. So now we have KP, we have the amount PL. Okay, KP plus PL. PL is this. Okay. So if you are going to write that, you will get KL is equal to KP is this, it is RA square minus R square cos square phi, square root is not there, minus R sine phi minus okay plus PL. Plus PL, PL is nothing but is a calculated RA square minus R square cos square phi minus R sine phi. Okay, so this is the required length of path of contact derivation.